guys, welcome to part two of the Techniques tape deck repair. Well, we've already established that we need gears. There's only two people that I found that actually have the gears, so that's at least it still works one side anyway. The board, I went ahead and used my tester. I tested all the large caps here. They're all actually good, they're in spec, but these ones here are not. These are all 220 UF. These are 6, 10, 10, and they're below 100 UF, so these all gotta go. I have 220 UF at 25 volts that I'm gonna throw in, replace all these. It'll be high EMF, so it'll work. So I figured I'd take you along with me doing that, and then we'll throw it back together and see if that gets rid of the intermittent problem with the soft touch controls. I still have a feeling that it's the chip itself that's on its way out, but we'll try it anyway, see if it helps any. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 of those. Pretty sure these are all the same. 25 volts. Cool. Not exactly the best caps in the world, but they will do. Definitely better than what we got here. Let's just test one and see. Two oh three. Sorry about the noise. That's my little think center there. It's going wild. These are probably all about the same, hopefully. 198. 199. Like I said, they aren't the best, but they will do. At least they're above 100, you know what I mean? .205, .206. They're not the same. That's alright, they're all good. Not gonna be to spec. Alright, let's get this thing out of here. The board's got a marking on it, thank God, because I didn't see the way I took it out. Next. Okay. one right there. So a little bit of heat damage around that one regulator there, so I want to reflow it just to remove that from the equation. One left. Oh, this one's gonna be a pain in the butt. If I got that right. Happened there. It looks like we have a bad trace. Yep. It's good enough. Got enough to work with there. The trace lifted. Yeehaw. That's what happens when you're flying through a repair. Fix that with the loop. Give me a minute. Okay, well, I found some more over here that were cracked. And we did these ones over here. We did the caps. Messed up the traces. let me throw this thing back together and give it a quick test, see if it actually functions. This portion of the build is pretty boring. Took a while to remember where all the parts went. This is one of the reasons I don't like to leave stuff laying around too long, so I don't have to go looking for a PDF on how to put this thing back together. There. Quick look around. There. We are done. Okay. Just get the base back down. sure we get all these cords in properly. Strictly for testing. Actually, we don't have to worry about the, we'll plug them back in. Yep, I would have mixed those up. Remember, I marked it. I was about to put it in this one here. So, whatever this one here, it would have been the selector that would have had the full power of the motor. That would have been interesting. Shorter than 6 volts. Here, this one's a little bit battered up. Like I said, you got to keep these things straight. It'll give you a hard time. This thing all together, and I forgot to put the screws in the plate, but I did test it, and it's pretty much the same. One thing I did notice, though, is if any of these pins here are dirty, or these little flappers, as it's coming up, like this one here especially, if it doesn't sense that it's been pulled in, it tends to screw it up. So I'm gonna grab a new container of Deox, and then we're gonna redo all these, and it'll probably help. Unfortunately, maybe I can do the buttons as well. I don't know, but these definitely need it. Because sometimes when it comes up, it'll click down and then come back up again because it's not sensing that's even working. So that's not good. So let's clean those up and see if it helps any. Well, Dean, one thing I do have is some really, really fine grit sandpaper. So just for a test. It is working better. But sometimes it does the double jump. So we're just going to drop some in here. It's not going to be that easy. The other ones are for recording and that. These are the ones that tell the microprocessor what condition or what's up, where the tape is. Is it up or is it down? Or the playhead. So. Dude, this thing is working really good. It's never worked this good. I think it was a combination of things. I think it was the capacitors that were going bad on the regulator, so the voltage was swinging all over the place. Yeah, it's perfect. Let's try the other side. At this point, I would get new gears for it. Worth it to me, even though it's got some mad scratches on it. But Wow, what a difference. That's it. So just deox all these points, and you don't even have to touch the buttons, and that's it. Well, double check all your capacitors, but I'm pretty sure all the main ones there are pretty good. I can't remember what it was, but they were fine. They were only dropped about a few points, so that's good. These ones were more than half. These are supposed to be all 220, and they're 100 UF, so that's quite a drop. But okay, it's not taping it. Yeah, running some really fine grit sandpaper through that works, but I'm still going to hit them with some spray just to be sure. Okay, I think we're done here. We don't even have to do with part three. Yeah, there goes that button again. Yeah, that thing seems to screw it up quite a bit. Yeah, just touching it. I'll have to, once I spray it, I'll adjust it and bend it or whatever. It's probably out of adjustment. It's been pushed on or something. Anyway, take it easy, guys. And if you do have problems with this not working properly, just go over these and check your capacitors. You should be good. Later. Sweet.